Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Welcome to a new day. It is Wednesday. It's 11, just before 11:30 in the morning, and I've already baked something. I made this quick bread cinnamon swirl loaf that was sent to us in friend mail. So thank you very much for this. And yeah, it looks good. It smells delicious. And so basically, it came with the mix, and it came with all this strudel or whatever it's called, and you pour the batter about halfway, and then you put some of this this brown stuff on top in the middle, and then you pour the rest of the batter, and then you put the remaining stuff on top. So yeah, it's it does come with a little pack of icing. But that's, I'm probably going to make some more so we could get a good amount of icing on there. So yes, thank you very much for this. And I'm sure it's going to taste good. And I just wanted to get it done early because on the meal plan for today, I had the pork stir fry. But I had also taken the turkey out of the freezer to thaw out in our mudroom. It's been cold enough, but yet warm enough so it could thaw. So it's thawed out now. So I'm going to go ahead and make the turkey today. And that'll be tonight and leftovers tomorrow, which is convenient for tomorrow because it's food pantry day. So it's just a matter of warming up supper. And then I'll do the pork stir fry on Friday. Yeah. So it still works out. We're just reversing a couple of the meals. And we'll have this for tonight as dessert. So, I think I'm going to go ahead and make my lunch. Glenn's going to have his leftover dip and cucumber on rye bread. He'll have that later. He just woke up. And he usually doesn't like to eat when he just wakes up. I think a lot of people are like that. But for me, I think I'm going to go ahead and use my leftover refried beans for my crispy bean and cheese tacos. So stay tuned and I'll get those going. All right, everyone. So I'm going to make my crispy bean and cheese tacos now. And this is the leftover refried beans from the can I opened up yesterday. And you can say this is a food pantry meal because the refried beans came from the pantry, as did the shredded cheese. We had the tortillas. So just an easy, delicious meal to make with your food pantry items. So this is all cheese, shredded cheese. I just put whatever I didn't use in the frying pan from the frying pan yesterday. Yesterday, what I did with my, these are flour tortillas. I did put them in the microwave to make them a little bit more pliable to fold over, but they're fine. So you don't necessarily have to do that. If it was a corn tortilla, probably. And these were super delicious. And it was quite filling. I'll probably still even have enough cheese for another time. Or nut cheese beans. Depending on how much beans you put in your taco. Yeah, there's going to be plenty of beans for something else. So if you're one person, if it's just you, and you like refried beans, and you like this kind of stuff, I love this kind of stuff. You could take one can of refried beans and make many things with it. You could use it so many different times. So I had two tacos yesterday. I'm having two today. That's plenty enough for at least two or three more, if not, or use it for another meal. So you could get three or four meals if it's just one person, just you. You could probably get three or four meals out of one can of refried beans. Not bad at all. Get yourself some tostada shells, make some tostadas. So many different things. All right. I think I'll just save the rest of the beans for another meal or another time. I don't know if I'll eat more of these the following day, but like I said, I love these kind of meals, so I could probably eat this more so time and time again more than Glenn. I'm just going to go turn the stove on. I've got some butter in there. You want to have some butter in there. That's going to make your tortillas crispy. All right. Just going to fold them over. Yeah, today is quite a messy day. It's snowing now. And it just kept changing. Rain, snow. But right now it's snow. We didn't get 6 inches or even 3 inches, but I don't know if we're supposed to, I don't know if it's supposed to go through all the way through tomorrow. We've gotten quite a bit of rain this season already. All right, everyone. So here is another day of bean and cheese crispy tacos. So I'm going to enjoy lunch. And I'm probably not going to put the turkey in the oven till about 2 o'clock or so. It's not even barely going to take 3 hours to make it. It's a smaller turkey. So, all right. And, yeah, so stay tuned. All right, everyone. So I'm getting ready to put the turkey in the oven. It's preheated. And for those of you that haven't seen the way we make our turkey, this is the bottom of the turkey. The breast side is on the bottom, and we cook it that way because the breast is always the driest part. So while it's cooking, it's staying in all the juices that the turkey is creating. So we've been doing this for many years, and we haven't gone back to the traditional way of the breast side up. So we cook the breast side down so it stays in juices. I've got the neck and all those little giblets in there. So yeah, this will take about 2.5 to 3 hours. It's an 11-pound turkey, so it's pretty small, but way big for us, for two people. It's going to feed us quite a few meals. All right, so I'm going to get this in the oven, and we'll see you in a bit. All right, everyone, so let me show you what I've got going here for this Thanksgiving meal in April. I'm going to be microwaving some sweet corn. I've got salt, pepper, and butter in there. Opened up some cranberries for Glenn. I've been munching on that. You can see the whole end piece. Well, it's sitting right in front of me. How can I not munch on it? I'll do something and then I'll go get a forkful. I got my fork over here. I'll just get a fork of it. And then I'll do something else and I come back and get some more. So that's dessert. Let me show you what else we got here. All right, so I've got the can of candied yams in there with some marshmallows to sweeten it up. I've got the mashed potatoes done already. And I've got an empty saucepan ready for making the gravy when the turkey's done. And the turkey should be done shortly. And I think that's the only thing we're not having, as if you would in a Thanksgiving dinner, is the stuffing. So yeah, we're almost ready to eat. All right, everyone, so here is our Thanksgiving dinner in April. So I cooked up that turkey, and there's so much left. mashed potatoes, sweet corn, candied yams, and some rolls left over from Easter. So that is, and I already gave Glenn his cranberries. So, all right, so that's going to do it for our Thanksgiving dinner in April. And don't go away, because I've been working on one of my craft projects, so stay tuned. All right, everyone, so I have finished this crafting project with the butterflies in the corner. So I did put an inspirational phrase on there, and I know Corey, I want to thank you for giving me the inspirational phrase you had. I had already come up with this one, but I really appreciate it. I was looking for a butterfly quote or phrase. I love inspirational phrases. So I was trying to think of something to put on here. I went through Google and looked through some, but then I just started coming up with my own, I guess. So I just kind of put bits and pieces together and I just came up with this. But thank you so much, Corey. I will definitely keep that one in mind for another project. All right, so as you can see there, I printed this out, the wording on my transparent sticker paper. And that it is definitely good for because it's just black lettering, but it just says, if you can't read it, every day I wake up, it's a blessing. How I live each day, it's a choice. And I just put be kind, be positive, be grateful, be inspirational. So I like what it looks like. Yeah, I really like how it came out. And yeah, I think it just came out really nice. Instead of hanging this up, it's gonna stand up. I put the kickstands on the back. So I am gonna put it on our what I call holiday table, but it's an all year round table. So let's see what it looks like on the table. All right, so I just wanted to show you the finished project on that. All right, everyone. So I just wanted to go over something, maybe to help some of you out. I was talking to one of the subscribers, and we got to talking about phone and storage for putting photos and things like that on. And what came about is the person has an old phone and a new phone, but hasn't transferred over to the new phone because she has a lot of pictures of her dog who passed away, and she didn't want to get rid of those pictures. So I basically said, why don't you just put the pictures on an SD card, which is additional storage on your phone, and then put that SD card in your new phone. So in the conversation, what came about is she didn't know about the SD card. So for those of you that don't know, with the exception of the iPhones, you can add extra storage to your phones. Now, many of you may know this, but some of you might not. So your phone comes with a certain amount of storage. That's when you take pictures and video. If you have music, it goes on your storage. So, and the phones come with a certain amount of storage. And if you use up all that storage, there's nowhere else to put that stuff on, the pictures and the videos and things like that. So what there is, it's called a micro SD card. And again, if you already know about this part probably isn't for you, but for those of you that don't know, you can add storage to your phone. I apologize. My phone is catching up on everything, I guess. But I put it in my hand. This is basically it's very small. It's about a half inch long, and it's called a micro SD card, if you can see that. And they sell them in different brands and different amounts of storage. This one in particular is 128 gigabytes. So I bought a big one like that. I actually have two for when I put my bird cams out. And this takes up to 5.5 hours of bird cam video. But depending on how you have your settings, but that's a whole nother thing. I just wanted to let you know, for those of you who don't know, I apologize that for those of you that don't know, you can buy. Okay, so for those of you that don't know, you can add storage to your phones. Again, with the exception, I believe, of the iPhones don't have extra storage capacity. What you buy on that phone is what you get. So So again, micro SD card, you can order them on Amazon, you can get them at Walmart, you can get them in many stores. The prices vary depending on how big the storage is on it. Not how big the card is, but how much storage is on each card. They come in 32 gigabyte, 56 gigabyte. This one again is 128 gigabyte. They go up to a terabyte, which is like 1,000 gigabytes. So I believe when you order one or buy one, it may come with this, which is what the SD cards used to be, the size of them. On the older laptops, you can slide one of these bigger ones, but they transferred over to these little micro SD cards, but they still left a little slot that you can put that in there and put it in your laptop if it still takes a bigger one. Most newer laptops, at least from the ones we have, only take these micros. So these are kind of obsolete almost. Your phone most likely comes with one of these little pins to open up a compartment on the side of your phone. So this is a Samsung Galaxy A21, a mid-grade phone. But most of the phones, don't matter if they're mid-grade, high-grade, low-grade, will come with the compartment. So I'm going to show you how to do it. Let me see if I can find it here. Okay, so on one side of your phone, you actually have your buttons for your volume and your power button. On the other side of the phone, you're going to see a little hole there. And that's why they give you this little thing, this little pin. And that's where your SD card and your SIM card, is what runs your phone. Oops, I'm pushing buttons here. Okay, so it's called the SD card slot or a SIM card slot. So I have the, hopefully you can see. You just look on your phone for a little hole, and this should go in there. And you push it in, and the slot, I don't know if you can tell. Okay, so it's saying no SIM card inserted, and that's because I popped out the compartment. You can see it sticking out a little bit over here, right here. So this pops, this once you pop it out, it just comes out. And you can see a hole there. That's where this card goes. Now, if you pull it all the way out, this white card is your SIM card. It normally comes with your phone. That's what runs your phone. That's what your service is. That's your SIM card. Your SD card, your micro SD card, goes in this slot. And there's little notches in there that it fits in there flush. And then once you got it in there, you just kind of hold it in there and push it in all. Oh, it's coming up. Yeah, you gotta be careful that you kind of guide it in flush. Otherwise, it will slide out of there. And pushing in all the way, and it locks in. So you can see it's no longer sticking out. All right. So once you got it in there, I'm going to go back to my phone. Oops. I was pushing all kinds of buttons here. And then you'll go to, it's a little icon with a folder on it. It's called My Files. You open that up, and it tells you your storage. Internal storage means the phone storage and the SD card. If you have an SD card in there, it'll show up as SD card. So it tells me I have 113 gigabytes used up of this card. So I think this is the last bird cam footage I have that I haven't gone through, and this is from way, I think, in winter still. So what it says here, like the internal says says I have 28.54 gigabytes used up out of 32 gigabytes. And then my SD card says I used up 113 gigabytes out of 119 gigabytes. So if you see SD card there, that means you put it in right and it's there. So now, let's say my SD card said 0 gigabytes used or 10 gigabytes used. Whatever that number is from that number, you subtract that number from this number, the left number from the right number, and that's what you have left on that card for storage. So I have 6 gigabytes left on this SD card that I can put photos, videos, music, whatever I want to put on there. Okay? So that's how you add additional storage to your phone. And when you take video or pictures with your phone, if I go to my camera, you press on your camera icon, in order to put those videos and photos to your SD card rather than the phone, because you have to make it so it goes to the SD card on your camera. Sorry about the lighting. You see this little button here? That's your settings on your camera. If you push that, if you keep going down, okay, you'll have something that says storage location. And right now I have it on SD card. So let's say you don't have an SD card in there. It'll say internal storage. That means all your storage from your photos and everything are going on your phone. So in order to change that, just tap on it and tap on SD card. And now you're set to take photos and videos and have the all those things go on your SD card rather than your phone. That's the way to save up the storage on your phone. So I just wanted to go over that for that person and for anyone else who didn't know about adding additional storage to your phone. So this is a picture I took. This is not the whole picture. I just cropped it to put it on my phone. But yeah, I took this picture years ago. But anyway, so yeah, I just wanted to show you that. If you have any other questions, drop them down in the comments. I hope this helped anyone who does not know about putting additional storage on your phone. And if you have a tablet, there's also one of those compartments where you can pop open. Any kind of pin will pop it open. The SD cards you can put in your tablets as well. So if you have stuff on there, you can transfer them, make the main storage on your SD card. And laptops, you can put them in as well. So, all right. Again, iPhones, I don't believe you can add SD cards to whatever you get on the phone is what you get. So, all right. So that's going to wrap that part up. And again, I hope it helps somebody. I know it helped one person, but I hope it helps other people as well.